Number 14. In an experiment, students set up an inclined plane at an angle theta on a horizontal table. The students release a block from rest on the inclined plane, and the block slides down the incline. The students record data for the time it takes the block to reach the bottom of the plane. This procedure is repeated 5 times, and the data are shown in the table. Which of the following claims could be supported by the experimental results? A. A buildup of dust between the block and the plane during each trial caused a decrease in the coefficient of kinetic friction between the two surfaces. That is not reasonable, since a decrease in the coefficient of friction will actually increase acceleration and therefore shorten the time, not lengthen it. B. The student placed the block closer to the bottom of the track during each subsequent trial, decreasing the final velocity. Once again, less displacement implies less time of travel, not more. Now let's jump to option D. Contact with the student's hand during the experiment caused the mass of the block to increase during each trial. A simple analysis could show that the acceleration is independent of the mass, so this shouldn't affect the time for traveling down the slope. E. The table that the inclined plane was placed on is tilted slightly upward. Since that could be true for all the trials, that is not the reason for the different times. Finally, if you look at option C, each time the student placed the block on the inclined plane, the incline was pushed downward, decreasing the angle of the incline. With a smaller angle, you will have a smaller x component of the weight and therefore less acceleration. So that is actually the most reasonable option, option C.